Hey everyone, this is First Warden Storm Team Chief Meteorologist Brad Penimich. Going into the month of December, we're finally here and it has been unbelievably warm in the southeast compared to last winter and really last November. Let's be honest, last November was brutally cold in the southeast, so this year has been unbelievably warm, so it makes it feel even warmer than it actually has been. Most areas in the southeast have had a top 20 warmest and one of the wettest Novembers on record. The problem is we've had no cold air in the eastern part of the country. So it's been a slow start to the ski season in the southeast. Is there any hope we're going to see a change in December? Some bad news, some good news. Let's start with a little bit of good news right now. We'll start, first of all, by looking at what's going on across the country. We've got a snowstorm, but once again, like we've seen the last couple of weeks and really for the entire fall, this big dip in the jet stream out west with a ridge in the east. The only thing that's helping us out today has really been a little bit of a wedge here in the southeast, making it feel cooler than it actually is. But if you know anything about cold air damming in the southeast, that makes it warmer aloft than it is at the upper levels of the atmosphere. So when you look at the radar futurecast, this is all rainfall across the southeast through Wednesday. A little bit of good news, I do think, is once we get towards Thursday, enough cold air could sneak in on the backside that we might see some snow up in Snowshoe, Wisp, Kanawha Valley, maybe all the way down to Winter Place, maybe a little bit of natural snow. So maybe the first sign that we're starting to see some northwest flow snow. I wouldn't rule out a stray snowflake in North Carolina, but it looks like there's just not enough moisture there. I think the bigger story will be if we can get some cold air in here. Here's the storm system over the Midwest. Again, snowing there, even though temperatures have been above average. Here comes this system on the backside. And notice we do get a little bit of snow. Not a bunch. I would say maybe 2 to 3 inches possible. Maybe 2-3 inches at Snowshoe, maybe 2 to 3 up towards Wisp, but it's going to be melting on contact with the ground. The ground temperature is just so warm. What about snowmaking? Sub 32 degree temperature forecast. Not a lot of cold air in the southeast through Wednesday. It really looks like Thursday might be the one night, or Wednesday night into Thursday morning, that we get a chance to make some snow. And then you could see again, it looks like on Thursday night. So maybe Wednesday night into Thursday, there will be some snowmaking opportunities. But when you look at the long range outlook going into the weekend, really above average temperatures here in the southeast. So this isn't, you know, really, really warm, but this is looking at temperatures probably a couple of degrees above average and really no true Arctic air moving in across the southeast. So when you look at the long range pattern, the jet stream is split right now. What I mean by that is the polar jet stream is up north. The subtropical jet stream has been very active. It's been bringing storms in. But the problem is when the polar jet is up here, it blocks the cold air from getting to the south. So we haven't seen a lot of that. The one thing that might help us out, and it looks like this happens late next week, is we get a deeper trough in the subtropical jet and it buckles the northern branch a little bit. So some cold air starts to spill south. And if you can get an upper low to spin in here, it'll bring its own cold air with it. And this is what it looks like on the temperature map. This is the 500 millibar chart as well as surface temperatures. You can see a quick shot of cold air the end of this week into the weekend. So there will be some snowmaking opportunities this weekend in the southeast, which is just a hint of natural snow. But what I really am looking for is a pattern flip, to see this change in the pattern where we start to see a dip in the jet stream over the eastern half of the country. And this big low, which forms late next week, just might do the trick. So the bad news is the first 2 weeks, I think, of December are going to be at or above average temperature-wise with not a lot of winter weather, just enough maybe to make snow every couple of nights. But there are signs mid to late month, the 15th and after, going towards Christmas, we could see a pattern flip. And that's something we'll keep an eye on as we get closer to the end of the week. The one thing you can look forward to this week is some chance of snow and some cold temperatures by Wednesday night into Thursday. But between now and then, just too warm and it's going to be rain. So think snow. We'll have another update coming up on Wednesday. Hopefully by then we'll really have to pin down some of these cold temperatures and some of that snow that'll be heading our way late this week. Hope you have a great start to your work week. And as always, think snow.